E55, this is the swap, the V12 swap. I'm talking about this car. So here I receive the middle friction bearing that already replaced it. That's the old one. This is the old middle friction bearing. Come on. Yeah. This over there is a new one. Here. That's the part number. Yeah, leave it down. This is the old middle friction rubber for the bearing that has a hole. This is the new one. Okay, let's fix now the middle friction bearing, and then we're gonna continue with the rubber coupler. Now, this is the front arms, the wishbone, the lower arms from the suspension. This is the old one. This helps looks like the old one. And this helps looks like the new one. It's solid, it's full. And this is the other one. That's the old one. That's the new one. The good benefit here, the good thing is that it doesn't have this space here, the new one. The same thing also from this side. This is the new one. That's the old one over there. And the same story from this side. Here there is an opening. But here it's solid. That's it. Let's put it on. Then, for the upper bolt joint, that's the upper bolt joint, the new one. And that's the other one. And yeah, this has also the middle friction bearing. That's the new boot. This is the new middle friction rubber and the bearing inside. Then these are the old one. This is the upper bolt joint that belongs to the customer. Actually, all this belongs to the customer and a couple of other stuff. Then, what else do we have? Yeah, the rubber coupler later. So let's continue with this. Let's continue with this because now I have to unpress this bolt joint here that's moving and install this bolt joint. Okay, let's continue. Bolt joint chains from both sides, and we are continuing with the rubber coupler. These are the old rubber couplers, the old bolts. This, please, when you finish, put inside the box there with the rest of the parts what we have. And here, that's the new rubber coupler. You don't have a light here. That's the new bolt. And that's the new rubber coupler, and this is the new rubber coupler. Mr. Omar, he fixed for us here the up, the bolt joint, the lower arm. Everything's nice, so we make some progress. Now we are trying to make to run two intercoolers, to run this intercooler with this intercooler. So here we have, this is the extension, the cable extension for the radiator fan, and this cable is from S65. I think S65 is the donor car from the car where we get the engine. Then we have one intercooler here. He fixed one very nice bracket. Let me turn on the light. One second. He fixed one very nice bracket that's bolting here and it's holding here the condenser. And there is also another one here, bracket for the condenser. And there is also another one here that's waiting to come like that. In this spot here, it looks nice. And there is another bracket here, and there is another bracket here to be nice and secured. The radiator has perfect clearance, This is one intercooler, this one core of the intercooler, and we will gonna keep also this intercooler at the same time. We're gonna run two intercoolers to be as much as possible the temperatures down. So we are making some progress. We are going forward with that. Then we have the fitting there need to be crimped. One fitting over there, and then there is also the other fitting down. Need to be crimped. For the front suspension, the only thing what we didn't receive it was the stabilizer bar links, and we receive it, and it's this one, that's the new one. This is the new stabilizer bar link, because what happening with this one is this rubber, it's coming apart. When we're gonna change it, you're gonna compare the new one with the old one to see the difference. This is stiff, this is not moving at all. The other one you can play left and right, and you can see that does it separate from the housing. What else? Where are we now? One small difference, the drives that what we purchase from a C63, the half piece, the front half piece, it's not correct. That's why I haven't put up to now the drive shaft. I return back the half piece that's going here front. I remove the boot because this is brand new. This is the middle friction bearing with the boot that we changed the brand new. We didn't install up to now the drive shaft because from the C63 need to be 1 centimeter shorter. So we give it back because it doesn't make any sense since we have to short also the new drive shaft. Then we are looking for the correct half shaft, the front piece, to see what we're gonna be. What else? The wiper blade, the rear wiper blade, it arrived. I just have it there on the windshield. The only reason why I didn't change it is because we opened the boot lip back over there, and this one minute job. That's why I didn't put it up for now. The new radiator fan and the cable gonna pass for the radiator fan from this side here. That's why we make these small modifications here on the radiator fan. It'll gonna continue down on the plug where it's supposed to be. Yeah, that's it, that's the status. For any other news, we are continuing. I'm gonna make another video. And another one thing, don't forget, we have to put the power steering fluid. We have to install this reservoir because there's no space to put it anywhere, and we have to make it like the other 55. Let me show you how it is the other with a V12 engine. I'm talking about this one. 1 second, I don't want to show the number plate. So the power steering fluid, the reservoir for the power steering fluid, is located here, exactly front of the coolant expansion tank. So we have to put on the same position, actually a little bit more high, to feed the power steering pump. All right. That's it for now. Thank you very much.